Since its inception over 7 years ago, Bistro To Go has become the go-to neighborhood restaurant for people from all walks of life. One loyal customer named Raymond has been eating lunch at the Bistro for over 4 years.
The cleanliness, the quality of the food, and the camaraderie, and everybody talks to everybody, you know. It's like you're in your own home.
With a menu that changes daily, customers never get bored.
Some of her inventions, her buffalo mac and cheese, it was phenomenal.
The food is the root of what we do. Just like I'm sure when Jesus was a carpenter, he built beautiful things.
The rough streets on the north side of Pittsburgh fill a special place in Nikki Heckman's heart. The idea for an upscale yet affordable bistro was more than accepted, it was demanded.
The community talked me into doing Bistro To Go. The community financed it. I had people help me fund it. I had volunteers everywhere help me open it. And in 3 months, I had a restaurant.
She has a real heart for the community. She takes pride in what she does. That's obvious. But if you look around and if you spent any time in the bistro, there is a real, real deep community relationship that goes on here. She engages with everybody, and she really wants to put Jesus on the street.
Heckman knew she wanted to help others since she was a young girl. Years later, she is finally starting to understand the calling on her life.
When I wandered into a church, I was anything but saved. And I was sitting there, and I was just captivated to help. So I did just that. I signed up before I was a believer, and I helped.
Much to Nikki's surprise, Bistro To Go became something bigger than she ever imagined.
And I thought, I'm going to open this little restaurant and do a couple $100 a day and mentor kids and bake apple pies. And God had other intentions.
The Bistro is more than a restaurant. The company has relationships with various organizations around the Pittsburgh area committed to seeing the community thrive.
So we get a good mix of people who really want to do some great things in our community. We kind of dream about what that looks like. And from our perspective, I mean, we really see this as a movement of God. We really believe that God can use anyone, and he does use anyone who's willing and able.
The restaurant hires at-risk youth for internship and mentoring programs and teaches them skills to help them succeed in life.
You know, a lot of times, you know, when you're working with people that are needy, you get beat up a lot. But it's learning to get that tough skin, learning that tough love, and being able to make that impact in their lives.
The Heckman's dedication to the people in the community is evident in every aspect of their work. The mission of the Bistro goes beyond providing a good home-cooked meal, although the food is to die for. The Heckmans strive to help people in their life transitions.
So I get great satisfaction with watching people interact in ways that bring healing and hope to someone's life.
Nikki Heckman does it all at the restaurant. From owner and operator to chef and minister, she doesn't have a lot of free time, but she does have her priorities straight.
When God speaks, we drop everything. It's about the reason we're here is we're a church in the community. And there is all different kinds of people that need Jesus.
Ministering to and seeing that her customers are taken care of is her most important work. And it's the food that draws them in.
What I found is I came to minister, and I found these people minister to me.
That work? Were you able to use it?
Yep.
So it works.
Yeah,
that's good. I figured it would.